Hello friends, hope you all are fine. Here I am with the last topic of chapter number 2, Nutrition in Ruminants. Children, in your junior classes, you must have studied about curd chewing animals like cows, sheep, camel, etc. These curd chewing animals are called ruminants or grass eating animals. Friends, you must have seen cows while resting, they keep chewing something. They always keep munching something. Have you wondered what they are chewing? Is it chewing gum? No, they are actually re-chewing the partially digested food. That is why we call them curd chewing animal. Curd means partially digested food. Like human beings, cows are also mammals and have similar digestive system, except that they have a four-chambered stomach. Their digestive system consists of mouth, food pipe or esophagus, stomach which has four chambers, rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum, small intestine, large intestine and anus. The food that they eat contains lot of cellulose, which takes long time to digest. Animals such as cows swallow large portions of food and later bring it back to the mouth for chewing again. The process by which ingested food is brought back to the mouth to chew again is called rumination. Now, let's study the process of nutrition in ruminants step by step. The first step is ingestion, that is taking in of food. Food is taken in, mixed with saliva and chewed partially. Ruminants have flat blade-like incisors which help to pull the grass. Also, they have broad teeth, molars, to chew the food. The second stage is digestion. That is breaking down of the food in the stomach and intestine. While taking in food, ruminants do not chew it completely. They swallow partially chewed food. This partially chewed food passes through the food pipe and goes into the stomach. Here you can see a picture of digestive system of cow. This is the mouth, esophagus or the food pipe. Then this chamber is called rumen. This is the first chamber of the ruminant stomach. This is reticulum. The third one is omasum. And the last one is abomasum. After this, you have small intestine and large intestine. Rumen is the largest chamber of the ruminant digestive system, that is ruminant stomach. It partially stores the food for some time. Partially digested food is stored here for some time. There are large number of microorganisms present which ferment the food. Partially digested food is sent to the mouth for chewing again. Reticulum is the second largest chamber. It helps in moving the food back to the mouth for re-chewing. Omasum is the third chamber. It is also the smallest chamber of the stomach. It absorbs the excess water present in the food and it helps in digestion of the food. The last chamber is abomasum. The walls of abomasum secrete juices for digestion. After passing from these four chambers, the food reaches the small intestine. In the small intestine, the juices from the liver, pancreas, and intestine digest fats, carbohydrates, and proteins. Digestion process is completed in the small intestine. The food is absorbed in the small intestine by finger-like projections called villi. The remaining undigested food passes to the large intestine. The large intestine absorbs water and minerals and converts the waste into feces. After absorption, assimilation takes place. The soluble nutrients are transported by the blood to the cells. Here, they are broken down to release energy. And the last process is egestion, that is removal of the waste. The waste is removed through the anus. So, dear students, this is how nutrition in ruminants takes place. I hope you have understood the topic clearly. Take care.